Dear students, the next topic is the multi-purpose tree species as well as the bioremediations of the soils. Bioremediation means use of the living organisms for recovery, cleaning up of a contaminated medium, either it may be the soil, sediment, air or the pollution. Bio means the living organisms, these are used for remediation, for recovery, cleaning of the contaminated mediums. That is said to be the bioremediation. These multipurpose trees are the trees which are deliberately grown and managed for more than one output. Whatever the trees which are used, which are grown and managed for more than one outputs, then these trees are said to be the multipurpose trees. And these multipurpose trees are used as a bioremediant for recovery or cleaning of the contaminated soil, sediments, air or the water. These multipurpose trees may supply food in the form of the fruits, nuts or the leaves. This can be used as the vegetables, while at the same time they are supplying the firewood. Add the nitrogen to the soil or supply some other combinations of the multiple outputs. These multipurpose trees are grown and managed for more than one output. One output in this may be the food in the form of the fruits, nuts or the leaves, which can be used for the vegetable purpose. It may give the firewood, it will add the nitrogen to the soil, supply others, some other combinations of the multiple outputs. Thus, these multipurpose trees is a common term to the agroforestry, particularly when speaking of the tropical agroforestry, where the tree owner is a subsistence farmer. These multiple trees is the term common to the agroforestry, particularly tropical agroforestry, where tree owner is a subsistence farmer. When a multipurpose tree is planted, a number of needs and functions can be fulfilled at once. They may be used as a windbreak, while also supplying the staple food for the owner. They may be used as a fence post in a living fence, while also being the main source of the firewood for the owner. They may be intercropped with existing fields to supply the nitrogen to the soil. At the same time, serve as a source of both food as well as fire. Common multipurpose trees of the tropics will include the Glaracea specimen, which is the most common tree used for leaving the fences, firewood, fodder, fixing the nitrogen into the soil. Moringa, that is the Moringa oleifera, it has the edible leaves, pods and beans, commonly used for the animal forage and shade purpose. Coconut palm, used for food, purified water, root thatching, firewood as well as shade purpose. Neem, limited use as an insect repellent. It can be used as antibiotic, adding nitrogen to the soil. Can be used as a windbreak, biomass production for use as a mulch and fire. Ideally, most trees found on the tropical farms should be the multipurpose and provide more to the farmer than the simply shade and firewood. In most cases, they should be nitrogen fixing legume or trees that greatly increase the farmer's food security. If we see the common multipurpose trees of the tropicals, In this, there is a Glaricidae species, moringa, coconut palm, neem, or all other tropical trees which found on the tropical palms provide more to the farmer than the simple shade and firewood. They will give the fixation of the nitrogen, increase the farmer's food security. Then we will see the advantages of the phytoremediation. It requires no outlay for purchase of the chemical amendments. Build up soil structure and stabilize the soil aggregates through the solubilization of the calcium from calcite, which has flocculating effect on the soil particles. Phytoremediation improves the availability of the plant nutrients by solubilizing the nutrients adsorbed fixed with the calcite. Besides enhance nitrogen fixation, phytoremediation facilitates the greater zone of the amelioration as compared to the chemical amendments. As and when we are using the chemical amendments, this will remain up to a few inches within the soil layer. But this phytoremediation will reaches to the deeper layers, greater zone, until the roots of that plant reaches. Thus, it will facilitate the greater zone of the amelioration as compared to the chemical amendments. The crop-based approach of the phytoremediation has shown effective low-cost amelioration intervention. If we compare the phytoremediation with the chemical amelioration, we'll found that even though it is a slow process, but this phytoremediation has the effective low-cost amelioration intervention. Phytoremediation is much cheaper as compared to the chemical amelioration. If we see the advantages of the phytoremediation, it doesn't require any outlay for purchase of the chemical amendment. As we purchase various kinds of the chemical amendments from the various outlets or the outsources. But for this phytoremediation, such outlet is not required. This phytoremediation will build up the structure of the soil. It will stabilize the soil aggregates. This will improve the availability of the plant nutrients. It will enhance the nitrogen fixation within the soils. It will facilitate the deeper layers amelioration as compared to the chemical amelioration. Effective low-cost amelioration intervention, cheaper amelioration than the chemical amelioration. These are the advantages of the phytoremediation. Selection of the plant species for the phytoremediation. This can be selected on the basis of tolerance of the crop to the salinity. Secondly, crop tolerance to the exchangeable sodium content. Whatever the phytoremediation plants or these trees, that should have the tolerance to the salinity. That should have the tolerance to the exchangeable sodium. And on this basis, we can select the plants for the phytoremediation. On this topic, we may be asked, what is meant by bioremediation? Explain it in detail through the MPTs. What are the advantages of the phytoremediation? Define multipurpose trees. Likewise, questions can be asked on this topic. We will stop here.